Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this section of Theory of Computation, we will be discussing the properties of regular expressions. In the previous video, we have discussed about the basics of regular expression. If you have not seen the video, please go back and see to it. Otherwise, you will not be able to grasp fully what I am saying in this video. Okay, so let's understand the basic properties of regular expression. These are very important from the examination point of view, maybe it any exam. Okay, so first of all, the first property says r plus psi is equals to psi plus r is equals to r only. Okay, where psi denotes an empty set. Okay, now if we multiply it, okay, if we concatenate it, not this operator, as I told in the previous lecture, it is the union operator and this is the concatenation operator. Similarly, to the addition with zero, you can resemble like that. If this is addition with zero, gives 0 plus r is equals to r itself, and regular r represent the regular expression. And if we suppose concatenate, we multiply with 0, then the result will be 0 itself. So instead of 0 there is 5, so if we multiply it with 5 also, 0 same as 0 only, so 0 is represented here as 5. So we are doing like this. Okay, so r dot psi is equals to 5 dot r is equals to 5. Now third property says that r concatenated with epsilon is equals to epsilon concatenated with r is equals to r itself. Okay, so we can represent it this as nothing. R concatenated with 1, so r multiplied with 1 gives 1 multiplied with r is equals to 1 r itself. Okay, so fourth property says r plus epsilon is not equals to r. Absolutely, suppose we are having epsilon a and all, suppose this is our set and r is only, suppose r is a and aa, so epsilon plus r is not equals to r. So this is how we can observe from the set, this language is not this language, so r plus epsilon is not equals to r. Fifth property says is that r star is equals to r star whole star is equals to r plus ka star and is equals to r star ka plus. That is, we can express it like r star is the clean closure, and clean closure will represent a complete language. Okay, so r star is a complete language, and if we make it, if we take the star of it, then it is also complete language. Similarly, if r plus is r plus r of star is itself a complete language, if we take r plus also, it is also a complete language, and r star plus is also a complete language. So this is, we can say as this is the property that says, suppose we r star is on the input alphabet a, we are having a and so on, is equals to, if we take one time epsilon a and do up to infinity, if we make a clean closure of it, then also we are getting the same thing. And this can be also seen like, if we take a and aa, it is lacking epsilon, but because of star, it will also contain the epsilon value. So ultimately we will get r star only. So that is this point has to be kept in mind. Now heading towards the next point, sixth point is that r star is equals to r plus is equals to r star r. Okay, so that is how we can denote it. Suppose a star is there is equals to a plus, because we are having all a itself. Suppose we are having a finite automata like this, which is accepting a and followed by star of a. So that is ultimately represented as a plus, because one epsilon is not accepted. That's why we are taking it as a plus. Okay, so that is how you have to do it. Now heading towards the next property, r plus epsilon. अगर हम आर प्ल वी इफ वी ऐड द आर प्लस विद एप्सिलॉन देन वी आर गेटिंग आर स्टार ओनली बिकॉज आर प्लस इज लैकिंग एप्सिलॉन इफ वी आर गिविंग इट गिविंग एप्सिलॉन टू आर प्लस देन इट इज अल्टीमेटली इक्वल्स टू द आर स्टार ओनली सपोज नाउ द नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी सेज इज ए बी ए स्टार इज इक्वल्स टू ए बी स्टार ए If we can say this can be derived by the Thompson constructions that is we are doing actually if we are making A B A star okay so suppose this is B A and B A star we are doing is equals to A B star that is A B star and A. That we can say that A is accepted, then B A the whole star is accepted. Like it will take strings like simple A, then A B A, then A B A B A like this and so on. If we expand this one, this will take A, then A B A, then A B A B A, and so on. So this is we are getting same strings. So these are equal. So we can derive it like this. Okay, now the next rule, heading towards the ninth rule. Okay, ninth rule says that epsilon star is equals to epsilon and epsilon plus is equals to also equals to epsilon. So this is a rule. And tenth rule is phi star is equals to epsilon and phi plus is equals to phi. So this is an exception. This is an exception, and this is very important observation, a very important property that has to be kept in mind always because the question comes here only. So how does it came? So how are we getting epsilon star plus is equals to epsilon and epsilon plus is equals to epsilon but still as phi star is epsilon and phi plus is phi. So how are we getting? Let's derive this thing. Okay, so we are deriving it by using Thompson's construction. For suppose a clean closure of a regular expression R is represented by like this. Suppose we are getting R and on transaction with epsilon. Okay. Okay, so we are representing R star with the help of Thompson construction like this, epsilon R, R is accepted and then we have to revert back. Yeah, this is the only thing I think. And R is accepted, then R, R square is accepted, R cube is accepted like this. And if we want to have epsilon also, we want epsilon also to be accepted. So I think yeah, you must observe this thing in order to get it. Okay, so I will make it more clearly. How is it working? So we have to accept R star with the help of Thompson construction. We are making it as we have to, the language accepted will be epsilon R R square, that is R R R R R and so on. Okay, so since we cannot represent loops and all, so we have to make it through the Thompson, whatever Thompson we have given us, we are going to do it like that. Okay, so R star is represented like this is first initial state is this, and then after that you have to on epsilon we are going to state where R1 is there, and then first of all we have to get what R1. So this is the final, and after that we have to revert back and you have to get R star. So back epsilon is there in order to get the anytime R1 you want it. So also epsilon is also required. So epsilon is also coming here. So similarly, this is R star and R plus is denoted like this, that initially R This is R1 and so this is epsilon. This is epsilon. So R plus is represented like this. If we put psi, then psi means nothing relation is there. So we have to remove this. So psi star is nothing but this one. Psi star is nothing like this. So it accepts epsilon. So psi star is epsilon. But if we remove this R1 from here, we are getting what? We are just getting nothing. So we are writing here phi. So this is what that needs to be done, and this is the proof of psi star is equals to epsilon and psi plus is equals to phi. Okay, phi plus, phi or psi, whatever you call it. So that is all for the properties of the regular languages. Some more important properties, not so important, but still we will be discussing those properties. Okay, so let's discuss them also. So R10 property is 11th property. It's A plus B is equals to B plus A. But A dot B is not equals to B dot A. And our 12-13 property says that A plus A is equals to A, but A dot A is not equals to A. Obviously, this A string is not equals to this A string. So now heading towards our next property, 14 property, that is A plus A star is equals to A star into A star is equals to A star only, and A into A star is not equals to A star because it is A plus. Okay, so now next property says, let's discuss the next property also. Some more are remaining. 15, A plus B star is not equal to A star plus B star. Obviously, this is missing. There are some missing properties, that is combination of ABs we are not getting in the right hand side part. So this is not equal. And A plus B star is equals to A star B star. This is also not true. Why? Because it is not giving us strings with B, A, single A, single B's. These are not given by this language, this regular expression. Now 17, A plus B star is not equals to AB whole star because it will result in AB, AB, AB like this, AB, AB. So some of the things are not accepted like A, single B. So there is a flaw here, so it is not equal. Now we are heading towards 18th property, that is very important property. A plus B star is equals to A star plus B star star, that is equals to A plus B star star, that is equals to A star plus B ka whole star is equals to A star B star star. This is important. This one is specially important. Otherwise, we can also derive others according to us, but this is new for us. Now, next one is A star surrounded by A plus B star, B star. So, these two are important in the for the examination point of view. So, keep it in mind. This property is very important. Okay. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe and comment if you like the video. Thanks for listening. Bye for now. Thank you.